welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we are finishing up our Elite 86 reviews for you guys, as well as ranking the full set. Now, I will say in this video, probably not going to take a ton of time looking at the Fiend figure because it is a straight up re-release. You know, it's the Blue Universal Championship. We'll run through it like maybe very quickly and do a quick comparison probably for that portion of the video, but we're not going to spend a ton of time on it. So if you're worried about that, don't worry about that. We're going to run through it really quickly. We are going to take a look at Sid though, because I want to find out about that ref shirt and pants and stuff like that. But looking at Elite 86, I think it was, I guess we'll have to wait until the ranking video. We'll get these guys out of the packaging, see what we got, and rank the full set. But I'm very excited to rank the full set because I like doing the rankings, man. The rankings are, they make the world go round. So taking a look at the packaging, guys, if you wanted to see what they look like. You guys know that last year we did get the Fiend in the same wave. Elite 77 was the last time we saw the Fiend, in the SummerSlam wave. It looks like they pretty much just were like, this is a great opportunity to re-release the Fiend, so here we go. Here is Psycho Sid over there, or Sid Justice, if you will. They look pretty good in packaging. If we spin them both to the right, you will get an image of Sid and the Fiend there. On the back, you get the little bio reads, as well as images of the talent and some info, of course. You got the rest of the figures in the way. You got some other images of the guys there, both matching. Look at them. They got stripes. They're all looking good. And then that pretty much does it for our packaging of Sid Justice and Bray Wyatt. Guys, if you would like to grab these or any of Elite Series 86, be sure to go over to Ringside Collectibles. RingsideCollectibles.com, WrestlingFigures.com, either one. Go over there, use promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10%, as well as like a ton of pre-orders, a ton of stuff coming in stock soon. I mean, there's a lot of stuff flying around right now, tons of product coming in. I got a lot of reviews to get out. I mean, stuff's just going crazy. But with that being said, guys, let's go ahead and crack Sid Justice and Bray Wyatt out of their packaging. And there is Sid Justice and Bray Wyatt out of their packaging, guys. And I'm liking what I'm seeing so far. You know, they're a little bit, we got some good things going on. And we got some other things that are like, But I like what I'm seeing so far. You know, not like a ton of great things. But, of course, we will dive into all those things, take a look at the comparisons and all of that. Now, I will say, I don't really have a comparison for Sid Justice. You know, I used to have a Psycho Sid, I think, way back in the day. I turned him into Big Cass, so never really tracked it down again. It was a solid figure. It was just really kind of plain Jane, and I was like, what can I use this for? It was way back in the day, so making a custom out of that, doing all those things, wasn't that important to me to keep Psycho Sid in my collection at the time, because Big Cass was on TV every week and was a prominent role. And now looking back on it, that was a terrible formula. It was way too jacked to be Big Cass, but I didn't care. A lot of people do that, where you just throw stuff together and you're like, that's good enough for me. But what we can do, guys, is go ahead and just take a look at Sid Justice's accessories and then Sid Justice, and then we'll run it back and just do a comparison of the Fiend, not breaking down a ton of what he's got, and then we will rank Elite Series 86 from worst to best. So let's go ahead and do that. So getting into his accessories, guys, taking a look at the referee shirt, the pants, all of the good stuff. This is actually really nice. Now, when we first saw the images of this figure, I thought that they were going to be like together, I thought that would be like shirt and pants combined. Just the way the images looked, it kind of looked that way, but it is separate. It looks really good. It is the tank top there with the stripes for the referee shirt that he wore, and you could put this on a lot of different guys. If you want to run stuff in your pick feds or stop motions and stuff, this is a really great accessory that you could use. So that is absolutely beautiful. And you have the solid black pants, and this could come in handy a lot, especially if this Sid Justice figure ends up going down in price. You could get the striped shirt for a lot of stuff. You could get a lot of pants for your Rock figures, your Brock figures, all that stuff. So like, you could use this for a lot of backstage promos, different gear and stuff, and they look to be pretty good size, so they would fit a lot of people, and I think you would be really, you'd be really good with that. So hopefully this guy drops in price at a later date, then you can load up on these pants and stuff. That's just what I would do. Next up is his interchangeable hands. Now, out of the packaging, he does have his mic holding hands, which are always absolutely beautiful. As the referee, you gotta have a pointer hand, not only to count, but also be like, what the hell are you doing, Brad? So you get two pointer hands, and then what's really cool is they included pinning hands, or, slapping the mat hands. So here are those. So it's the same Ricochet style hands, but they are, you could slap the mat for the 1, 2, 3. That's pretty dadgum cool there. And if you guys were wondering about Bray Wyatt's accessories, just really quickly, you get mic holding hands, you get a Blue Universal Championship, which we've seen quite a few times now, and then you also get the hurt heel hands, or the little pose like handshaking hands, or whatever you want to call these. So that's pretty cool there. But now that we've covered his accessories, guys, let's dive into Justice himself. So getting into Justice himself, guys, starting out at the head sculpt, I want to say this is a new head sculpt, but it may be that one basic in the blue gear. I can't remember. It's not coming to me off the top of my head. I want to say if I had to, you know, make a final answer, like freaking Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, I would say that it's not a new head sculpt, but I may have just lost my million, Brad. Anyways, looking at the head sculpt, I like it regardless if it's a re-release. It looks just like Sid, I think. I like the expression. I like the hair sculpt and everything like that. Sid was absolutely jacked, so I really like this torso. The arms look really good. You know, he was massive, and this fits for him. I want to say this is his WCW look, if I'm not mistaken. You know, it's the, like, we already got the black gear, and we didn't ever get the blue gear, which I thought is what we would get here, but it looks like they went with his WCW gear underneath the cloth shirt and pants, so that you could use it for two different Sid Justices. So you could have the WCW version, you could also have, you know, the referee version or whatever you wanted, but you get the red singlet there, white wrist tape. For some reason, it's just a really unique look for Sid, not one that a lot of people, I don't think, commemorate him with. I don't know, I may be wrong about that, but it's not what I commemorate him with. But there's the figure. Man was 6'9", 300 pounds. Absolute giant tank of a man. Going down, you do have the red singlet, like I said. You also have the red knee pads, white socks covering the calves there, and then you get the long black boots. Hopefully he doesn't snap his leg in the middle of this video. Now, if we wanted to back it on up a little bit, again, not the most exciting figure ever, but a figure I think a lot of people are going to want in their collections when it's all said and done, even if they sell this part of the figure. I know a lot of people are going to be wanting the ref shirt and pants, so that will be something as well, but I like the figure. It feels good in the hand. Really good stuff there. I don't have any issues with it, but there's Sid Justice, guys, and let's go ahead and dive into our comparisons with the Fiend, because I don't have the other Sid Justice to compare with the Psycho Sid. So taking a look at the Fiend, guys, with his comparisons here, you have the Ultimate Edition on the left, you have the new release in the middle, and then you have the Elite 77 or the Top Talents on the right. I think this is the Top Talents version. For some reason, I can't find my brown hair version. I may have customized it or turned it into something else or something like that. I do have a mock one over there, I guess. I could have opened for the video, but I don't know. I've had it mocked for so long, it's just like, eh. Anyways, diving into the comparisons that I notice, the only notice I'm really seeing is the hair is flipped. So you guys can see how on this release, the hair is on that side, and then on this release, they flipped it because his hair could go on either side, I guess. And then the legs look a bit more accurate. I would say that this one, the updated one, does have more accurate legs, I would say, as far as color and things of that thing, you know, as far as those things go. But I still feel like he looks a little bit stumpy. Not as stumpy as the Ultimate Edition, because he is a little bit taller, but I wish that, you know, if with this re-release, they could have done a little bit better with the formula, but I understand it. You know, it's not a massive deal. It's just something that, you know, if I wanted it. They also did not put the prayer hands on the chest again. I don't know if he had it at that moment or not. I want to say he did. He has it on the back of the packaging, as you guys can see there, but I thought we would maybe get a cloth jacket with this guy or a different head sculpt made, but I mean, technically it is a new head sculpt because the hair's flipped, but you guys get the point. But there's the Fiend figure. I didn't want to dive into it too much because how many Fiend figures we've already gotten, but let's go ahead and rank this set from worst to best. All right, guys, it is time to rank at least 86 from worst to best in my own personal opinion. Now, you guys know how the criteria works, right? I mean, it comes down to excitement for the release, you know, how quality is the figure, the accessories, head sculpt. I mean, there's a lot of things that play into it, you know. The excitement level for the figure is probably near the top as far as that is concerned, and then impression with the figure, you know, feel it in the hand, posing it around, also plays a massive role in it as well. But breaking down this set, if a figure comes in at dead last, it doesn't mean that it doesn't have any redeeming qualities, and just because it's number one doesn't mean it's perfect without any flaws whatsoever. So now that we've covered all that, guys, let's go ahead and dive into our ranking. Now, coming in at the bottom, this one wasn't like the hardest thing to do, just because I guess I've seen it a lot and it just was like, oh. So for me, guys, coming in at the bottom, you guys could probably already guess, it's gonna be the Fiend figure. Now, I think solid, like overall, it's a great figure. If you guys miss out on the Fiend, it's like fantastic. But if you've owned like the three or four other Fiends that we've seen and all that, I think if it included a cloth accessory or it changed the head sculpt a little bit more, or maybe it was a different look of the Fiend, or they redid the formula, maybe it could have been a little bit higher. But for me, man, it just wasn't like, I just was not excited whatsoever for the figure. So had to put it at the bottom. The Fiend comes in at the bottom, and that's kind of crazy, but you know, sometimes you gotta just coming in at number five, guys, I'm gonna go with Sid Justice. Now, I don't think it's really fair to say that, you know, this figure's not good, because it actually really is. I like it and everything like that. I just didn't grow up with this version of Sid. You know, I didn't get to see this Sid live. I like Psycho Sid, I like Sid Justice, but I don't know, it just isn't a release that I typically just was super excited about. I think the ref shirt is amazing, the pants are amazing. I like the figure, it like looks good, feels good in the hand, and the head sculpt's really impressive. It's just just one of those things where I couldn't really relate much to the figure, so therefore it's going to come in at number 5. Coming in at number 4, guys, I'm going to go with The Miz. I really like the figure. I think it's fantastic head to toe, really. It's just a re-release of Elite Series 69. I think maybe if they changed a few more things about it, or maybe his accessory, you know, his entrance coat was something clever and unique and like something we haven't seen before, or a cloth accessory, maybe would have bumped him up a couple spots or something. But the white gear is super nice. It's a really great Miz figure. I highly suggest you track it down. Great re-release of a figure, great white attire, but it does come in at number 4 for me for that reason. And also, I'm not the biggest Miz fan, as cool as the figure is, so that is also a thing. Now, coming in at number 3, guys, I'm going to go with Triple H. I really like the Triple H figure. The head sculpt's really nice. I've been waiting on this attire for him for a very long time. Purple's not the most accurate. I like the cloth shirt. Just overall, a quality release, and it is really nice to see this head sculpt with true effects. And again, the attire's nice. Been waiting on this Triple H for a while, and the t-shirt is epic, so Triple H is a great number 3 spot in Elite Series 86. And now we're coming down to the pink and black male and female of the set. We got the Carmella, and we have the Seth Rollins. Now, this actually was actually, you know, this is a pretty intense battle that we were having right here, but at the end of the day, guys, I think I'm gonna go with Carmella number 2 and Seth Rollins number 1. The Seth Rollins is just excellent, man. I can't wait to get fix-ups in here. I did get my extra 2 in the set, so you guys know that surgery is about to be freaking wrecking house. We are gonna bring back surgery this week. After I get all these reviews out, I still gotta get some reviews out. We have ringside exclusive Cena. We got the ringside exclusive Jurassic Express. We have surgery coming up. We got a great week of stuff coming up, and I still have, like, you remember that big mound of stuff the other day? I still did not get all of that taken care of because it's so massive, and I got, you know, a lot of stuff going on. So we're gonna get all that squared away, but the Seth Rollins was too good not to put at number 1. The head sculpt's fantastic. I love the way it looks. The beard, the attire is amazing and everything like that. The only thing I think keeping Carmella from number 1 is maybe just, like, her ankles get a little bit loose, but it's such a good women's figure, man. Like, oh my god, it is incredible. Like, no doubt about it, this is one of my favorite figures released so far this year. But you want to see my top 6 or ranking again: Seth Rollins number 1, Carmella number 2, Triple H number 3. Stand the hell up when I'm saying something. You got The Miz at number 4, you got Sid at number 5, and you got The Fiend at the bottom. Overall, really enjoyed ranking this set, reviewing this set for you guys. If you guys would like to grab these, ringsidecollectibleswrestlingfigures.com to pick up any of these, as well as a ton of other things, man. Tons of pre-orders and things like that, so definitely go check it out. Use code MDTOYS to save 10%. For a random shout-out, guys, it's going to go to El Comic Quero, or Caro. He says, bro, that transition was fire, and I did it again in this video, so hopefully it's just as fire, but a huge shout-out to Quero, or Comic Quero, for that. Thank you so much for commenting, man. If you want a random shout-out in a future video, guys, comment down below, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, turn on the bell, and don't miss the show, you know? But that's gonna do it for my ranking of Elite 86, man. Had a ton of fun with it. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and don't cross the damn line like the Fiend figure. Like the Fiend figure!